this Friday for a big event at the Norfolk Scope. That's on May 2nd. Tickets are on sale at the Scope Coliseum. Bob Chavez and Ticketmaster. Jimmy Hart, the Barbarian Humorist, will be at Bar Fresh at 1200 North Military Highway, 10 a.m. to noon, with tickets go on sale Friday, April 2nd.
Tony, Canada's own.
What, Brady?
Canada's own Bret the Hitman Hart. They love him.
A well-deserved ovation in his home country. And I would venture to say, Mike, today, that he is not going to do what Chris Jericho did to his countrymen.
I would say that's a pretty safe bet, Tony. The excellence of execution is in the ring. He's got a microphone, and maybe he'll explain a little further about that challenge that he issued last week to Goldberg, where he said that he could defeat Goldberg in 5 minutes.
5 minutes. Was Canada's greatest athlete. I think this man, Bret Hart, has far surpassed that. Taking nothing away from Gene. But this man is great, like him or not.
He's a remarkable athlete, there is no denying that. And he's a credit to our sport.
And so is Gene Kaniski. Matter of fact, he owes me $12.
Yeah, right.
Canadian.
It's nice to be in a place where you get a little respect. It's nice to go to a place where you see some kids in the audience, too. Now you sit back there all night and you sit back and you listen to everybody. And I know everybody's all up in a big... You know, everyone's all upset about the ratings and stuff. So I'm not going to worry about very much tonight. And I think I'm going to start off with a little bit of O Canada. Our home and native land, true patriot love, in all thy sense command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise in the true north, strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Hey, Bischoff, put that in your pipe and smoke it. Now, I've been in the WCW for over a year, 5-time world champion. The best there is, the best there was, and the best that there ever will be.
They love him.
And I can't get a match with anybody. You got Ric Flair, the world champion, back there hiding under a table somewhere. You got Hollywood Hogan. I guess he's afraid of me. You know, I'm gonna get right to the point. I came to the WCW to earn a reputation, not to lose it. And I got one point I wanna make. I wanna prove that I can excellently execute any wrestler I want, anytime I want.
They're behind him.
So let's cut to the chase. The franchise player, William Goldberg.
The man.
You big chicken. He thinks because he's built like a tank that he can run over top of me. Well, I'm not going anywhere, Bill Goldberg, till you come out of that dressing room, biting your fingernails, trembling with fear, because he could take me on right here tonight in Toronto, Canada.
Let's do this thing. What do you say?
Let's get it on.
The man.
He's putting up all this money to take on Steve Austin. Well, let me tell you something. I beat Steve Austin every time I ever fought him. He likes to fancy himself some kind of big, fancy, tough football player. Well, I got news for you, Bill Goldberg. This is hockey country, Bill Goldberg. Put away your silly helmet and come out here and fight me.
I'd like to see that. Don't look at me. There's nothing more I can say to add to this. It just got to happen.
Moments ago, here's what happened. The spear. And the spear that took Bret Hart is taking everybody out. But it also took Goldberg out. We were wondering why. We couldn't understand. Bret Hart shows us exactly why. What a move. What a well thought out move this was to put Goldberg down. But then Bret Hart said he quit. He said, Bischoff, I quit. Talking about Eric Bischoff, who's signing to a contract here. And Bischoff, we hadn't seen Bischoff in I don't know when, comes out here and confronts Bret Hart. This happened moments ago. You didn't see it. It happened while we were in a commercial break. What's that all about? I have no idea. But the fact is, he says he's quit. He says he